In this session, we'll be looking into how we can create a fake wireless access points in our vicinity. So I'll first verify if my monitor mode is enabled through admin-ng command. And here you can see that my monitor mode is enabled. So we had discussed in our previous section that MDK3 is the tool which will be used to create the fake access points. So there is a test mode called as beacon flood. We have talked about beacon in the earlier chapters. So what I'll do is, I'll open a new tab and I'll run Wireshark so that we can analyze the packet level details. I'll start the capture on the non-zero interface. I'll stop the capture for a while, and here you can see there are a lot of beacon frames, and along with the beacon frames you can see the name of the SSIDs, and these are basically the wireless devices which are available in my area, and there are a lot of them. So what we'll be doing through MDK3 is we'll be creating such fake packets with the fake SSID values. So let's see how we can do that. I'll stop the capture, and before doing that I'll run MDK3 command. MDK3 followed by the interface name followed by the B. B stands for beacon flood. So I'll start a new capture and I'll run the beacon flood mode. So what this will do is, it will send fake beacon frames with some random SSID parameters. So here you can see there are a lot of random SSID parameters, and it is sending a different channels at a particular instant of time. So if I can stop the packet capture, here you can see SSIDs with some random names which are available, and it is sending to broadcast domain. So any wireless device in the vicinity will be able to see these wireless packet captures. So this is one of the modes of the MDK3. I'll stop it. Let's look on how, if we want to send out beacon frames with a particular SSID name. So we can do this with MDK3 mon0 followed by B-N and your SSID name. So let's say cyberspies@. And I'll restart the wireless packet capture and I'll run this command. So you can see it is sending out beacon frames with the SSID cyberspies@. And if I can see in my Wireshark, you can see there are a lot of beacon frames which are there with the SSID cyberspies@. So this is the second mode which you can work with MDK3. The third interesting mode, I'll just show you. I'll go to the SMF folder. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll create a file with 1 to 100 numbers inside it. So I'll use a sequence command starting from 1 to 100 and write it down into wifi.list file. So if I go into wifi.list, you can see there are 1 to 100 numbers. Now what if I want to broadcast beacon frames with each of this number? So in order to do this, I can run MDK3 followed by the interface name followed by the beacon flood and wifi.list. So it is, you can see it is sending out random packet with different SSIDs available inside the file. So if I start my Wireshark again, you can see various SSIDs with number 16, 15, 13, 12, 10, etc. So this is one of the simplest way to spam your area with the fake wireless access point. So I'll just close this down. Now these are the three modes that we had discussed, and many people use this kind of attack mainly for spamming. Please note that when you try to connect to these SSIDs, you won't be able to connect. This is just and sole only for spamming purposes. Now I have seen many devices which will not show you any Wi-Fi with these names, and the problem with this is because the MDK3 is sending out lot of Wi-Fi beacon frames with the same MAC address, and this seems to be triggering alert in many of the mobile devices. So what you can do is you can include the hyphen M option, which will basically change the MAC address each time it will send a beacon frame. And once you do this, your mobile or your laptop machine will be able to detect the beacon frames. So this is all about creating the fake wireless access points. This is not an attack, it is just for spamming. We'll be creating a fake wireless access point for attacks in the later modules. So I hope you have learned something new in this lecture, which is a bit interesting also. And I would like to thank you for viewing.